Hello folks, my name is Ramana. I am part of Azure Identity Cloud Engineering team in Microsoft. Today I am going to discuss how Microsoft Intune integrates with device-based CA policy. I am also going to show you a demo on how to create device-based CA policy. A good understanding on this will help you troubleshoot device-based CA policy with Intune. Let's ride in. Let's see a quick recap on what is conditional access. Conditional access brings signals together to make decisions and enforce organizational policies. Conditional access policies are their simplest or if and then statements. If a user wants to access a resource, then they must complete an action. If the action satisfies the CA policy requirements, then the access is granted to the resource. If not, the access will be denied. It enforces organizational policies before the user is granted access to the resource. Azure AD conditional access is at the heart of new identity-driven control plane. In here, we are going to see how device-based signal is integrated with Intune in conditional access policy. Intune can integrate with conditional access on device compliance state and with app protection policy. We are only discussing here on device compliance. Organizations who have deployed Microsoft Intune can use the information returned from their devices to identify devices that meet the compliance requirements, such as requiring a PIN to unlock, requiring device encryption, requiring a minimum or maximum operating system version, requiring a device is not jailbroken or rooted. Policy compliance information is sent to Azure AD, where conditional access decides to grant or block access to the resources based on the device's compliance state. Intune administrator can create platform-specific policies and define the requirements to mark them as compliant. The policy then can be assigned to users or groups. This enables the administrator to set compliance policy as per the organization's requirements. Now let's see how to access the conditional access plate from the Intune admin portal. Access the Intune admin center from endpoint.microsoft.com. On the left hand side, click on the devices section, and on the down below you can select conditional access. That will bring you to the conditional access landing page, where you will be able to see all the configured conditional access policies. You can also access this conditional access plate from the Azure portal. Navigate to portal.azure.com and in the search box, type in conditional access. On the results, you will see Azure AD conditional access. Once you click on that, it will take you to the conditional access plate, where you can see all the configured policies for the tenant. Now let's see a quick demo on how to create device-based CA policy. Once you are in the conditional access blade, click on New Policy. Provide the policy with an appropriate name. Now scope it to the users or the group. In my example, I have selected a group for all employees. Click on Next. Now select the scope of this policy on which applications you want to scope. In my example, I have scoped it for Office 365. On the grant control, specify that require the device should be marked as compliant and say select. Now you can turn this policy on. Now we have successfully created the conditional access policy, which requires a compliant device to be able to access Office 365 application. Now let's see how this looks like from the Intune admin portal. From the Intune admin portal, you can see the compliance state of all the devices by navigating to the devices section and clicking on all devices. The compliance state is a result of the devices meeting the all compliance requirements defined by the admin. This compliance state is reflected in Azure Active Directory. Let me show you how it looks from the Azure Active Directory. You can see this information in the Azure Active Directory by navigating to All Devices section. And here it shows the compliance state section, shows the compliance state for all the devices. This device state result is used by the device-based CA policy before granting access to the resource. I hope this video was helpful to you, and thanks for watching.